this episode of Look Around You, we'll be investigating the Pele Institute, located in Southern California in the United States of America. There, the students learn hands-on STEM education in deep, enriching ways. Reaching far beyond the classroom walls, it is the mission of the Pele Institute to teach experimental education and science to youngsters. This program, entitled STEM Education, is located in Chapter 732 in your corresponding textbook. Please ensure that you have your copybooks in hand, as you will be asked to take notes at various points during the film. In relation to the article entitled Interaction Between Science Teachers and School Principals and Its Influence on Technology Implementation, the success of innovative education and utilizing technology in the classrooms depends on the school's environment and the principal's attitude. Teachers who had the opportunity to be trained using specially designed software and well-developed web-based learning materials were more apt to implement the technologies in the classroom. And the more often these teachers used these technologies, the more confident they became in using them. According to a 5-year study that explored the effect of principals on teachers' implementation of technology by Pellet, Kali, and Dory, there is a direct correlation between the principals' attitudes and the teachers' comfort level and use of technology-based instruction. So in the end, supportive principals were involved in the process and encouraged teachers to use web-based teaching strategies. History of the outdoor education. According to Neil, it is unclear when and where the true beginnings of outdoor education lie. However, some look to the evolution of the human species. Only recently, in the past 100 years or so, did learning take place in the permanent structures such as schools. Prior to that, learning took place in the outdoors, where natural living things, challenges, rhythms, and observations took place. In today's post-industrial 21st century, there seems to be a need to maintain some contact with the natural processes and the environment. 1930 marks the start of short-term residential camping in the United States, and with the invention of the Outward Bound program, which was founded in Wales, began in Colorado in 1962, which helped them to create two other project adventures in 1971 and the National Outdoor Leadership School in 1974. Outward Bound in Colorado helped to increase the interest of United States citizens in outdoor education. Paul Petzloff, who was employed by the Outward Bound in Colorado, noticed a need to educate and train individuals to become outdoor education leaders, and so began the National Outdoor Leadership School, followed by Project Adventure, founded by Jerry Pear, who was formed to bring adventure based on learning principles of Outward Bound into the classrooms across the United States. In the 1970s and 80s, many, according to Neil, similar and more specialized adventure-based programs were developed. And then, of course, the Pele Institute, founded in 1990. According to an article entitled Why Immediate Support for STEM, Science, Technology, Engineering, and Mathematics is So Critical by Kathy Douglas, we see that in the United States of America, there are less and less college students majoring in mathematics. This means that there are far fewer qualified math teachers than needed in schools. And as a result, fundamental skills in basic math and science have decreased in the past 30 years. And in referencing another article entitled Instructional Capacity and High-Performing Schools by Cochran and Gertz, we see that one of the major sets of issues concerning reform in states and school districts centers around the idea of capacity of these systems to achieve the goal of helping all students reaching high standards of achievement. Other issues, as Cochrane points out, include intellectual ability, knowledge, and skills of teachers and their staff. The quality and quantity of the resources available for teaching, including staffing levels, instructional time, and class size, and the social organization and instruction or instructional culture, all need attention and reform. Of course, these reforms will not come without understanding what teachers need to know to be able to implement what is necessary for these schools. According to the textbook, The Global Achievement Gap by Wagner, that the tests students must take in high school for state accountability purposes usually measure 9th or 10th grade level knowledge and skills. However, they rarely ask students to explain their reasoning or lack of student creativity. Other inconsistencies, as pointed out by Wagner, include 6 survival skills. Number 1, critical thinking and problem solving. Number 2, networks and leading by influence. Number 3, adaptability. Number 4, initiative or entrepreneurialism. Number 5, effective oral written communication. And of course, number 6, accessing and analyzing information. It was also noted that very few teacher preparatory programs focus on developing the skills needed to be an effective teacher. It was also pointed out by Douglas that because of certain factors that prevent students from pursuing fields of science and mathematics, the United States itself is weakening in its once powerful role in research and development. That's why it's ever more critical for youngsters to study STEM education. What is the future of STEM? Well, science, technology, engineering, and mathematics are a large part of our world today. So open your eyes and look around you, and you will see that STEM in schools is important for our future to improve. The importance of schools is to educate students by preparing them step by step into the world around them. Our world today is filled with new science, a ton of technology, and better engineering and math than ever before. The reality is, people are living longer today and have better health because of the stronger and better use of science education those doctors are given. Broadband internet access is used from computers to smartphones so individuals can find answers rather than look them up from a textbook. This advantage and use of STEM in our world starts from schools that put it into their daily practices. Learning other subjects are still needed in schools, of course, so the use of science camps can allow students to gain information faster and with good detail. The Pele Institute is a model for such STEM outdoor education that is needed in the United States of America. It is located in the San Bernardino Mountains near Lake Arrowhead in California, and it is truly an outdoor education leader in its own right. The staff at the Pele Institute provides around-the-clock supervision and instruction for these youngsters. And they are highly qualified individuals who have a passion for the sciences. The curriculum the staff have developed there in outdoor education, science, and leadership is truly without an equal. The goals of the Institute are to increase the students' understanding of relevant science and concepts, while also focusing on awareness of personal growth and leadership team building. Students leaving the program have an awareness of the sciences and the natural world, as well as confidence in themselves and with others. In conclusion, since science, technology, engineering, and mathematics are such a big part of our world, schools should give students the education they need, because these students are the ones who will build the world that awaits. Now hand in your copybook to your teacher or head of class.
some bad hat, Harry.